That's a lot. A unicorn.
For corn.
Walk.
For where you go from.
Yes, it sort of fears up and it's your. And then.
Don't feel so lonely. You know, there are a lot of people out there who are feeling really like alone.
I know.
Which I feel like I really get it, because especially lockdown, you can't even go out.
No.
That's the thing.
I feel sorry for those people.
Yeah. For me, during lockdown, I was going back to introvert itself. I was just watching Netflix. I'm not sure you've watched Netflix. And I'm just having a good time and just relaxing. Think positive. It's the most important thing. Thinking positive.
Yes. We haven't got Netflix.
Oh.
We haven't got a smart
TV. All you need is a computer or a cell phone.
Yes, we've got those.
But yeah. It's like Sky, you know, Sky, the TV broadcasting.
Yes, we've got that.
Yeah, it's like ESPN, Sky TV, that kind of thing, but for like movies and TV shows.
Yeah.
Once you start watching, though,
you can't stop.
Yep, exactly. It's one of those things. Episode 1 finished. Oh no, I have to watch episode 2. Yeah, it's definitely a corn.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Wow, never knew that.
Looks pretty big though.
I've had it cut off 2 or 3 times.
And come back?
Yeah, it always comes back.
That's because it's where the pressure is, always the heel.
Yes.
That's where the pressure keeps, it just never changed.
There's a lot more traffic around now.
Oh yes, the traffic's is back up now. So partly everyone's back into business. Although we're in level 2 lockdown, I do think things are starting to pick up a little bit more. Although we're going to wear the effects of the lockdown sooner or later. I think there are places where people are actually going to lose their job, which is really sad.
Yes.
I just pray that they're okay.
Yes, well, what was it, one of the big places today?
Oh,
a lot of people.
Where was it? I wasn't sure. I heard there was 1,000 people, though.
Yeah.
1,000 people who, like, got redundant.
Wouldn't that be awful?
Yeah. It only just happened today, and on the news, I'm working, so I can't watch the news, but...
I think the Prime Minister's done a wonderful job.
Yeah, Jacinda, I love her.
Yes.
Like, she's willing to go lockdown when people, like, other people are trying to, like, no, we need the economy. But honestly, safety first. Yes, if you don't have health, then you can't do anything.
She's amazing.
Yeah.
She's gone through an awful lot of things. I mean, she had a baby and...
Oh yeah.
and her husband at first was looking after the baby, but I think her parents are now, because she's in Wellington and they live in Auckland.
Yeah, I mean, you're that busy, especially COVID-19. You'll be very busy.
Terrible.
Yeah.
So it's a terrible thing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad my parents. Went alive to see her.
Mm. What about your rest of the family? Are they okay?
Yes. But a daughter at Rangiora.
Mm.
She's okay. And son here just down the road.
Mm. Okay. At least got some family around.
Yes. Yes, I think I'm very lucky.
Yeah.
if I needed anything, I'd just ring the ones that are close by. And my grandson doesn't live very far away.
I have a church group that I go to, and we can't do church anymore, but we just do online now.
Right.
So we just gather online once a week, and yeah, just chat and fellowship, you know.
That's good.
That's good.
Are you married?
No.
Oh.
Ah, I wonder why everyone keeps asking me, actually. I'm still single, for all the people on the video.
I would have thought that you would have been married.
Yeah.
You have a girlfriend?
No. I'm still single.
Gosh. Nice looking young man like you.
Well, isn't that the most wonderful thing you just said to me? It made my day.
So where are you from?
I am from Hong Kong. Came here when I was really young. And been here for a while. And now I'm a podiatrist.
And any of your family here?
Just my mom. So far just my mom. My dad is in Hong Kong working. Still has his job, so he's going to keep it for a while. And sister's working in Hong Kong as well, so yeah, the four of us.
So what's it like in Hong Kong with the virus?
It's like SARS all over again for them.
Is it?
Yeah. It's sort of getting a little bit better now, but like there was recently like a few cases, so I'm not sure if there's going to be a second wave coming. Hopefully not. Yeah.
Mm.
What's worse is there's a second wave and you don't even know it's coming, you know?
They still don't really know how it started though, do they?
They say bats.
Bats?
Yeah. I was watching Man vs. Wild like 10 years ago, and there was this one episode when he talks about eating bats and then how there's a virus in there called coronavirus. And I was thinking, wow, if someone ate that, someone might get this virus and becomes human, like human to human instead. And then 10 years later, oh my gosh, this came up. I was like, oh my gosh. I was just thinking like, oh, maybe one day it would happen. And one day it did happen. Oh my gosh, jinx. Jinx again. Does it hurt anymore?
Yeah.
It was a flat corner, probably protruded out, but I've taken it off.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Pretty clear there. Yeah, good thing I think New Zealand handled it really well. Everyone was really doing their part.
I think so too.
No one was, I mean there were complaints and things like that, but like yeah, overall, pretty good.
Yeah, I think the rest of the world.
You hear on the news, the rest of the world is like, just like, just suffering, you know, really badly. Whereas New Zealand, you feel really safe and you don't, I mean like, you can just run around the park and your people will reasonably like sensible. So we'd be 2 meters apart. Yeah, I mean, there's one or two idiots once in a while, but yeah, everyone's relatively pretty good.
Yes.
So yeah. Well, if it doesn't hurt when I press on like that.
No.
Pretty good. Oh, that's all right, that's all right. A unicorn is what it is. So this is, you know what a corn is?
Yeah.
You have a unicorn. Good one. Now usually I just cut it like that with a clipper, but I feel like there's no fun in doing that, so might as well get it done like this. Makes my life enjoyable on a boring day.
Yeah, part of the time.
Yeah. Sometimes you have to find ways to enjoy work and make it a little bit interesting.
Yeah, well, the last job I had before I retired was the best job I'd had in 45 years of working.
What was that?
I was Public Enemy number one.
What?
Walked around town, got paid to piss people off.
What?
Yeah.
What'd you do?
Parking warden for Wilson's.
Was the pay good?
There's some funny times, and sometimes people just didn't know what they wanted to do, so they wanted to punch me.
You got some battle scars, eh? You should show them your unicorn.
Assault.
Oh my gosh. You've been through a lot.
Yeah, that guy had an interesting day in court, apparently. I was laughing all the way.
Yeah.
And the lady had a push in, ripping to a guy who was abusing me. Boy, you should have heard her language. I learned some new words. She was about an 80-year-old.
Speaking English, or?
English lady, yeah.
Okay.
And ripping into this Pakeha, right? Oh, man, the language he used on him would have made the whole US movie blush. She had more than a sailor's mouth. And she was respectably dressed.
Visually pleasing, then changes a lot as well.
Yeah, she lived in flabbergasted, and I was trying not to let my pants laughing.
Oh, well. You here with me now?
I got physically assaulted once, and I...
You got assaulted once?
Yeah. I got grabbed from behind and spun around, and as I spun around, I just threw the punch out, collected him flush on the chin, and knocked him out cold. That was up at Avonhead Mall.
Avonhead Mall? Is it? That's a pretty small mall, though.
Yeah.
Avonhead's a pretty good area, though, huh?
Yeah. Oh, this guy got a bit disgruntled that I chalk-marked his tyre when his car had a flat battery.
Flat battery in his car,
yeah. But what they don't realise is... The time limit starts from the time I chalk the tyre, not for how long they've been there. Okay. I don't know how long they've been there. So I put a chalk mark on the tyre, note the time. And that, when the time has expired, I'll go back. If the car's still there, then he gets a ticket.
Well.
Well, I mean, say like Avonhead Mall, a small place, but it had a 3-hour time limit.
True, yeah. Three-hour limit, that's quite long for a shopping mall.
It is, yeah. Well, you'd say, Pagans Ave, one more house there, that's 90 minutes.
Yeah.
Even that's...
3 hours, you have more than enough for a small mall like that, unless you work there. Yeah. I don't know.
Well, the staff weren't allowed to park on site anyway. So.
Yeah, your staff doesn't park there, they park at the back and all this stuff. So, I don't know, it doesn't make sense. Looks like it was bleeding down here before. Probably didn't feel it because you had a little peripheral neuropathy. Probably can't even feel me touching your foot.
No, I just feel a little bit of a pressure down again, that's all.
Oh, pressure, yeah. The joys. The thing is, like, I don't have to worry about causing you pain or anything like that.
Nah.
That's the best part.
Unless you try and amputate the toe.
Oh, am I? Oh my gosh.
Don't forget, it's me that's holding the big stick.
Oh, I'm holding the blade here.
Yeah, well, look at that.
Bringing a knife to a blade, walking stick fight.
Yeah, well, I've got a t-shirt at home that says, fight me if you wish. But remember,
oh, I don't want to mess with you, no.
But remember, I'm old for a reason. And I was out at Eastgate at the ATM there one day. A couple of young guys in front of me, one turned around, read the t-shirt, put a smile on his face, nudged his mate. And then they both turned around.
My gosh. He's got some really interesting fight stories here.
And they said, well, you think you're that good, do you? I said, no, I don't think so. I know I am. Oh, yeah. And I said, well, I'm out here talking to you. Then I looked at my t-shirt, showed them my scar.
Oh my gosh.
Good, right?
Oh, you got, that's like a shark bite or something on your waist.
the guy that brought a knife to me is still in hospital.
Why?
Didn't tell him it was a surgeon though, did I?
Well, you got some very interesting stories for me to hear. And for the people watching as well.
No, there's only one person there, but I don't think they were listening to what was being said.
My gosh. So look. It's quite a deep one, isn't it? A tall and fairly deep. There we go. So I think just get to here, should be fine. Is that why you carry that walking stick?
No, it's just to help me keep my balance.
It's got multiple uses. You got to multitask with everything.
Yeah.
You see, it's good for holding you still, and it's also good for defense.
Yeah, but
and also reaching for stuff as well.
Yeah. But it's not really designed for fighting, this one.
There are ones that are designed for fighting? Walking sticks are designed for fighting?
Yeah. There are combat walking sticks.
You're kidding me, wow.
They've got grooves.
Oh wow, I thought you were going to say spikes or something like that.
Yeah, well, the grooves go in, but yep. They're like flat sort of grooves, top and bottom.
Yep.
And the handle has a hook on it, a fairly wide hook with a sharpened with a tapered point on it.
Are they actually meant for killing people?
Yeah.
Wow, really?
Yeah, well, let me say, you hold a stick like this, and where the grooves are, there's one at the top end, one at the bottom end, and they're designed to push into the face and drag.
For a corn. Oh no, I dropped it. Which taxi driver drove you here?
Oh, I got Blue Star.
Okay, Blue Star, yeah.
I did have Gold Band, but and they only charge 5 drivers to come here.
Oh, man, look at this. Break it down. Take out the little bits and pieces around here. They're a pretty huge one. It's been causing you a lot of trouble, I can tell. Those are phonics though, you've been pushing it on the outside of it. What I mean is, it's been pushed outside, so it's rolled around in the shoe. Careful. Sorry if I'm pushing your foot too much. It's going to get that skin tension. There we go. Did you do much this weekend?
Mine, not really. I go to a group during the week.
A group?
People my own age all meet. We have a meal at the rooms. We meet them and I do the housey. Only I don't do housey the way everyone else does. I do it my way. And they all love it.
Oh, okay. Sounds interesting.
It's my version of the housey calling.
You have a fun time with them, meeting new friends, and it's better to be with people than to be isolated.
Sure.
Really don't what happens is a lot of people get isolated, and they're like really, really like it just gets really lonely and sad, and that's where a lot of depression comes from. And I'm really glad that you actually took a step out into. Especially with mobility issues as well sometimes, that you're willing to go out to actually chat with people.
Hey. Yeah, I spend every Tuesday morning at the group.
Great. You should play some, like, maybe walk around the park or something and stuff. Like, having good walks around is also good. This one's really close to the skin here. Let me see if I can go this way. It's a really deep one. It's just like a huge one, so that's why it's so deep as well.
Really, one truly dark. The man that brought me here in this taxi.
His skin is dark, is that what you mean?
Yeah.
I wonder where they come from.
I did wonder where he came from.
What? From where you go from? Right now it's really thick and really protruded out. There's no way I can go in, so it's always protruding outwards. Because directly touching this is the bone.
Yeah.
Have you been smoking? Have you been smoking?
Yeah. Nothing will stop me doing that.
I know there's nothing much I can say.
I know.
But I really highly, highly recommend not smoking. A lot of it will cause you a lot of pain. Sorry I have to say it. It's part of my job I have to do.
Sorry.
Have you ever been to the other podiatrist? Around here?
Been where?
Other podiatrists.
No.
Okay.
And it normally costs me $5 to come here.
Oh, I see. So this is the closest one for you. Okay.
He charged me $9 this morning.
What?
That's a lot.
I mean, like, yeah, usually it's $5. Must be a different driver then.
It was an Asian driver.
An Asian driver?
Yeah.
Ooh.
I don't know.
I guess that's...
He asked me if I had a mobility card. I usually do, but my mobility card's run out. So get another one is $50.
Wow. $50 for that. Usually corns hurt when you push it. They really do get painful when you pull it. Oh, yeah. Oh, came off. Pretty intense one. Starting to see a lot clearly now.
Pardon?
I'm seeing this a lot clearly now.
You wouldn't credit something like that would be so sore.
Surprising what little things can cause pain.
Yeah. I need these shoes too, but there's nothing I can do about it.
What shoes, oh, it's these ones that you currently show me, right?
Oh, those are worn right down on the heels.
Yeah. I can give you a $30 discount, but it's really hard. Let's see. Oh, I think I dropped it. How does that feel?
Yeah.
Is it better now?
Yes.
I couldn't put pressure before.
No.
I think partly it's just that you're a little bit afraid of me touching it every time. I can tell.
Yeah. You can.
Even when I did this, you were jumping.
Yeah.
Oh, it's okay. No, I get a lot of patients who actually come in who are really scared, and like, you'll be surprised what the mind does to the, like, pain reception. Like, I actually once injected myself with a needle, and I knew it's gonna hurt. But like, I think it's just my mind that was just making it even more painful than it is supposed to be.
Yeah.
My mom's a phlebotomist, so she sometimes she taught me how to like draw blood and stuff. It's directly on the bones. I really
sort of feels up and it's sore, and then I forget all about it for a week or so, and then I realize it.
Wow. Ooh, it's like a little mouth like a crocodile. Does this hurt at all?
Wee bit, just starting to feel it.
I think no matter what, it's gonna hurt a little bit, but I'll do my best to make it really.
I'm just starting to feel a bit. No pain really. I just know that it's just, that you're doing something down there.
Yeah. Right. Let's get this right.
So there's not many people in Metlow's permanent sailors that can say they've been on a aircraft carrier and down in a submarine.
Yeah.
And on a cruiser. Never got onto a destroyer.
Ooh, this is not easy.
The thing that I remember most with the submarine was after the couple of hours down below. When they opened the hatch, it was just a boom in the ears, you know, woof. The air pressure. And when they must have lifted, I was down in the engine room. I was a stoker. And they must have lifted. The hatch.
Ooh.
And boom.
My gosh. If you see that, man, that's a huge corn. That's a huge, very huge one. Look at that, look at this. Can you see this?
No
matter how blind you are, you must be able to see this. This is how it looks like.
Yay.
See how big it is?
Is that a corn, is it?
Well, it's the callus of the corn, and it's, wow, it's been there for ages. It's so hard as well. Not gonna lie, it's a pretty intense one.
So now that you've got rid of that, that should heal, shouldn't it?
Well, it definitely took out all the pressure away, that's for sure. Definitely takes away all that pressure. Ooh, there we go. Yeah. It's a wee little bit here.
Yes, well, as I say, it's been there for months and months and months, but I don't know anything about it for a week.
Yeah.
And then I know something about it for 2 or 3 days.
Mm.
It hurts, and then it doesn't hurt.
It doesn't hurt? Really?
I just know.
Really? Well.
But then it, usually during the day I forget all about it. I get used to the to it.
Mm. Do you have any other conditions? Like, do you have diabetes or anything like that?
No diabetes. I've got pretty well everything else.
I think it was all that Navy time and all that foot you've been through. I can tell you must have been through a lot.
No, I like a leaky valve, heart valve.
Mm.
We I'm down to 7 milligrams a day.
Okay.
We're up to started at 20, and then for a month down to 15, and then for a month down to 10.
Okay.
But I collapsed twice. I finished up in hospital twice.
At least you're okay now.
Anemic, because they put me on prednisone. They got the digoxin.
Oh my gosh.
That's the blood thinners.
You had everything, don't you?
The mega trend. Metropol. Finasteride.
Metropol?
Salacipol. They've cut the aspirin out when you put me on the mega trend. The mega trend, he started on 150. And then he dropped it down to 115.
Mm-hmm.
But then I collapsed twice and finished up in the hospital.
Gone.
So he stopped the aspirin, and I'm on 75 now. To make a trend.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yep.
Next week is my 3-monthly visit. So, what you'll find, I don't know.
Well, but I hope you have a good result coming up. Definitely, man, I took this. I nailed this like a man. Dry skin around here, so I just feel a little bit.
I didn't understand.
That's okay.
Nice.
Almost done with this one. Your mighty mountain has been taken away now. And then Christian faith,
That 19, what?
Yeah.
What did you say then?
I said, as in the Christian faith, it says, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can remove mountains. And that's what I just did right there.
So,
there you go. That looks a lot better now. Right.